So it's been a minute since I've done a video like this where I'm just kind of sitting down and walking you through a shoot, but I'm really excited about today's shoot. I am doing some large format, moody, creative portraits of a friend. I've been setting up for about an hour now. So I want to walk you guys through the lighting setup that I have today because I think it's going to turn out very cool. But I think the truth of the matter is I just don't have a ton of gear. I mean, I know I am lucky to have the gear that I do have, but there's always been one thing or another that I haven't had that's kind of put this shoot off. And I decided today I was gonna make it happen no matter what, and I was gonna figure it out. And so that's what I've been doing right now. I wanna walk you through my ideas and kind of how I got to this point. So I'm trying to vlog and light myself because it's relatively dark in here. But the first thing that I wanna talk about is right there. So they're motion sensor lights, and every time I move around, they turn on. So to fix that, since I didn't have a flag to just fly up there and block all that light, I ended up just getting a ladder and unscrewing those bulbs. That was a quick and easy fix. I wanna talk about this right behind me though. So this is the main attraction, I guess I would say. I do just wanna mention, I put two flags in the window seal right over there to block the window light so I could really be in control of the ambience of the room. I do have some Duvetyne over there, but I ran out of stands, so I couldn't just hang up a blanket over that. So that'll have to do for now. What we've got here is we've got a 6x scrim gym holding up some diffusion. And what that's gonna do is basically just create a blue ambience in the room, a very, very soft light. Right now I have a white backdrop. We may change that depending on what shirt she's wearing. Here's my Intrepid. I haven't done an official walk you through it kind of video with it yet, but that's coming, don't worry. The main highlight of this shoot is going to be this little spotlight that I have. It's an LED Chauvet. I think it's mainly used for theatrical lighting. And as you can see right here, it is a very fine, sharp light. And what we're going to end up doing is we're gonna have her sitting right here, and that light is just gonna kind of cut through her eyes and just highlight her eyes. Overall, I just wanted to have a little bit more control over this light. And you know, I'm in a garage, so there is a fair amount of space, but we don't have unlimited space. So what I have done here is I'm bouncing the spotlight into a mirror, and then it's gonna be thrown across her face while she's sitting in that chair. Since I don't have any more flags or stands, I just put some gaff tape over the mirror. And so the only thing that's being reflected is that slit right across the room. So now if I set this back up, hopefully you'll be able to see, but right here, we just have that little bit of light, and I might even make it a little bit smaller, but I don't want to do too much work until I get her in here sitting down, and I know how high tall she is and stuff like that. But like I said, overall, I think this is gonna look really, really cool. And the final touch I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a gel over that spotlight and turn it like red or something, and we'll have that nice red and blue look. We're gonna be shooting on Ektachrome 100, and then I might pull out the RB and do some Portra 400.